Hi everyone and welcome back. So in the last video we talked about the basics of the testing by creating our simple test library and assertion library. Now in this video we will start with the Jasmine. Okay, we can also even look for the Jasmine library, how it look like, what all features it provides. Okay, so Jasmine is a library which we can install through the npm, right? So if we just take a look at the documentation, this is our Jasmine library. Okay, what does it provides? If we go into the documentation, it's a BDD, right? Behavioral driven design, and it is supported by Node.js CLI. You can run Jasmine on the browser also. So if we just get started, then you can install Jasmine init. It will set up the project structure for you. Okay, Jasmine init will create a support folder with a spec with the jasmine.json, and it will allow you to just do the testing using npm test. You just add a script in your package.json. okay, you can also run Jasmine on the browser. Okay, this is for the JavaScript. Now let's see what we are doing here. So whenever this is Jasmine CLI, okay, here I created a basic project and I have written my test cases. And what these test cases all about? Simple mathematical functions. This is my source, this is my library, you can say. I have addition, multiplication, Fibonacci, simple function. Okay, I'm exporting these and I might be requiring these whenever I need a function. So here we should start using this describe it chain. Okay, so first we will talk about what this describe it chain is about, right? So this is the describe section. Here you can put the root of the section. Okay, I am testing math library. Now in the math library there may be a multiple functions, right? So what you can do is either you can just directly put the it sections here, right? Adds two number together or subtract two number together. You can import your library on the top. Here this is how const math library equal to require. So how should we structure describe it? That depends on what you wanted to test. Okay, this can be nested n number of ways. Like the whole section I can put as a nested. But what always you should take care is always keep this describe parallel to another describe. If you are putting a describe inside it, nobody is stopping you, but always think, okay, if there is a parent as a describe block, then create two describe child block. So we can maintain the consistency in our code. Now you can see we have the describe block which has two describe blocks here inside it. This is the first one, this is the second one. Now you can say math library, let's say happy path, math library unhappy path, right? So you can decide in what way you wanted to structure your test cases. Describe block will have another describe block, can have another describe block will have a it block. This is called it block, where you actually write your assertion, your expectation, the actual execution of function happens here, right? So this is how you can structure them. Describe can have multiple describe. Describe will finally have these it assertions. And you can use any kind of assertion library. Okay, like we are using expect. This is coming from Jasmine for now. Let's see this now. What we are doing here is we imported this mathlib. This can be imported on top also. And from mathlib we are using this simple function multiply and Fibonacci. And whenever you do npm run test. So if you see the support folder, when you do the Jasmine init, it will create a src spec folder for you. In the support folder, you will see the jasmine.json. Simple configuration, it is just saying, okay, this is a spec directory, this is your source code, nothing else. Spec directory is a spec folder is there. Look into spec.js files there. S can be capital or small. These are the helpers. Okay. So when you do npm run test in my package.json, I have a test script with the Jasmine. So by default, it will look for the CLI version, and there are three specs are there. Zero failure. Let's say we are failing one. And what will happen in npm run test? You can see one assertion is failing. Out of four, one is failing. When I just change it to back, then all are passing. Okay, so this we are currently running through a simple CLI. This can also run on the browser. So this is Jasmine is a library, right? You can set up a simple project. But in the current scenario where we have all these frameworks, React, Angular, Vue.js, we don't rather focus on setting up Jasmine, because these libraries are already plugged in with the framework like Jest with React, Jasmine Karma with Angular, and Node.js. You can use a Mocha Supertest request module. Jasmine independently is not that much useful, but when you use it with a Karma or any other library or any other bundler like Webpack, this is useful. You can also run Jasmine on the browser. So what you do is you create a Jasmine browser.json, and you will be using Jasmine browser runner instead of Jasmine module, and you will do Jasmine browser runner serve. Okay, I mean, this is all coming from the documentation, nothing from my side. It's just about when you are writing a Jasmine from CLI, always do a Jasmine init that will create a spec and source folder, and always create this jasmine.json in the support folder, because this is a configuration which will tell Jasmine, okay, this is a spec folder, this is a source code, and this is how you need to execute. Okay, stop spec on the execution failure, false. That means it will execute all, no matter who is failing, right? If you make it true, then whenever the first one is failing, it will stop execution there. Okay, so this is pretty much about Jasmine. Next we can talk about Jest, we can talk about Mocha, Chai. These are certain libraries. Okay, thanks everyone.